But first, being the whistleblower when it comes to fraud in a company. Joining us right now, we have Jay Kinnemer with McMahon Law Firm, talking about being the person to step up and report fraud. Lots of times this happens at a major company here, but sort of walk us through that scenario. There's someone who thinks there's fraud that's going on with that company or discovered fraud. First, you know, they're obviously afraid to tell on that company, but they are protected. Take us from there. What happens when that person makes that first call, or who do they call?
Well, usually it's either a government employee that's undercover, some type of government fraud, or it's an outside concerned citizen that can bring a claim if they discover government fraud. And usually that's in the what we usually see in the news around here, Medicare fraud or TennCare fraud. And it can be pursued individually on behalf of the government. And if the government picks up the prosecution, then the relator or the person that was the whistleblower can possibly be awarded up to, I've seen 15 to 25% is the norm of whatever penalties or fines that are awarded.
Now, obviously, when it goes to court, there's a chance that someone might be revealed as the whistleblower. Those first couple of stages here, what kind of protection do they have?
Well, whistleblowers, understandably, are apprehensive. If we get calls and we are looking into whistleblower claims, they're apprehensive about what's going to happen with their job.
Right.
Now, the statute has, either with false claims or the whistleblower statute, has anti-retaliation factors built into it. And when a claim is pursued, typically it's filed under seal. So the person's name and identity is kept secret until the government decides whether they want to pick up the prosecution. So I would encourage anyone out there that knows of, you know, some corporate fraud that's, because it's rampant, it's out there, to come forward, give us a call. They can call us without, you know, without the fear of being exposed right away, and we'll take them through the process.
Now, you mentioned the government sort of kind of helps out and investigates and looks into this as well, but the person that does the whistleblowing, I mean, they don't just kind of go away. They are rewarded, if you will, for doing a good job.
Yeah, and it goes back to the time of Abraham Lincoln, the Civil War. They wanted to give an incentive for good citizens or ones to come forward and expose corporate fraud, and do so without you know, the fear of losing their jobs. And there is a mechanism to allow them to do it anonymously until the government decides whether they're going to pick it up or not. And then after that, the anti-retaliatory discharge factors kick in.
Now, you see the big cases, the one that make the national news, and we've seen those time and time again. But as far as smaller companies, a lot of us work for, you know, corporations that only have maybe 100 or 200 employees or even less. What can someone do if they do suspect fraud there?
Yeah, if, for instance, there was a case up in Knoxville where one exterminating company knew another one was bilking the school board up there.
Right.
And there was a smaller amount of a recovery there, but there's also a provision for attorney's fees, double damages, things like that. But that would be a quietam action, and concerned citizens, even if they don't work for the corporation that they're blowing the whistle on, can step forward and say, hey, look, I know about this rampant bilking of the government that's going on here, and I want to be the one to help out.
Lots of times there's phone numbers and ways that you can call and report this that maybe larger corporations have. But again, going back to smaller, is this something that we call you and say, hey, we think this is going on?
Typically, we would have to go through feasibility of being able to pursue it, depending on how big it is. But yes, so typically that process would start with us.
All right, folks, it's all about doing the right thing. And then, folks, if you are interested in learning more about this or maybe what you can do, you can call them 423-265-1100. It's McMahon Law Firm located there on High Street in downtown Chattanooga. Their website is McMahonLawFirm.com. And Jay, as always, appreciate you coming and talking with us.
Thank you, sir.